If you're a ThinkPad enthusiast, I'm sure you've heard of the so-called Retro ThinkPad. But in case you haven't, I'll give you a brief overview. It was back in 2015, Lenovo released a survey on their website asking which features people would want to see in a new model designed to celebrate the 25th anniversary of ThinkPad laptops, such as a more traditional keyboard design instead of the chiclet-style keyboard that Lenovo had been using in recent years and which was quite controversial, especially when they decided to integrate the trackpoint buttons into the touchpad, a bad design decision which they quickly reversed but definitely did not win them many favors with longtime ThinkPad users. And after 2 years of waiting, the Retro ThinkPad was released in October 2017. It has a price of $1,899, and it does have the more traditional keyboard design, but unfortunately, despite Lenovo's own survey showing a strong preference for a 16:10 aspect ratio display, it has a 1920x1080 16:9 aspect ratio display, which I and many other people found to be highly disappointing. Now, I've been perfectly happy with my ThinkPad X60, which I've featured in a previous video, but from time to time I've been looking for a slightly newer ThinkPad, which still has these classic ThinkPad features, but with a larger screen, a faster processor, and more expansion capability. And I think I've just found it. This was a thrift store find. And yes, that was the price I paid, $29.99 plus tax. This is a ThinkPad T61. And you can see the size comparison there. So it is definitely larger, but not massively so. And my favorite feature, it has a 16:10 aspect ratio display. It has a couple more slots and ports, which I'll cover in greater detail when I give an overview of the machine. It did not include a power supply, but luckily I had a spare one on hand, which I actually found at the thrift store a while back. I originally just intended this to be a spare for my X60, but now it actually comes in handy for the T61. Also was missing the battery, so I went on eBay and found the cheapest battery I could find. Unfortunately, they put these stickers on it, which can't be peeled off without coming off in pieces. But what do you expect for 12 bucks? And at least for now, it seems to be working fine. There's also some sticker residue here, which I'll have to investigate the proper methods for removing that, because I don't want to use something on this rubberized coating, which is going to damage it. It says Centrino Pro, but it's actually a Core 2 Duo. Originally came with Windows Vista Basic, but the hard drive was missing when I got it. So I had a spare hard drive on hand, which actually came out of my Toshiba Satellite L305 when I upgraded that one to an SSD. I kept the old hard drive, so I just stuck that one in here. And it did not include the caddy, so I just shoved in some pieces of cardboard to keep it in place, and luckily it did include the trim piece, so from the outside it looks fine. Also, when I first got it, the keyboard bezel was popped up around here, which made me afraid that somebody had taken the RAM out of it, but when I opened it up, I was happy to see it still has 4 gigs of RAM installed. And I think what happened is that somebody opened this for some reason. Maybe they thought they had to remove this panel to remove the hard drive. I don't know. But they did not seat the keyboard correctly, and that was causing the bezel to be popped up. So I fixed that, and now it looks fine. And of course, it has the traditional ThinkPad keyboard. And this one is actually in very good condition. All the texturing is still on the keys. It's not heavily worn out. Trackpad still looks fine, as well as the track point. So this computer likely did not have very much use at all. The display is fine. This is a slightly smaller 14-inch display. You can also get this with a 15-inch display. There's no webcam up here, but it does have the track light for illuminating the keyboard when you're typing in the dark. Looking around the perimeter of the laptop, we have a cooling vent, VGA monitor output, 56K fax modem, gigabit Ethernet, two USB 2.0 ports, which are vertical, which I'm not really a fan of, because when you have something with a larger housing on it, like this wireless adapter with a high gain antenna, it's not gonna fit without resting on it when you plug it in, so not the most convenient design for those. This has a PC card slot and a express card slot, IEEE 1394 FireWire or iLink port, whatever you want to call it. It's the 4-pin version. Hardware on-off switch for the built-in wireless. Headphone jack, microphone jack, the latch for opening the LCD, There's where the hard drive goes. There's the optical drive. It's a CD burner and DVD reader. You could also get a DVD burner for this, which I may do. One more vertical USB 2.0 port. On the back is a Kensington lock slot, the battery, power input, and another cooling vent. On the bottom is the information stickers, the socket for the docking base, your Windows Vista product key, which you're free to copy because who cares about Windows Vista these days. No trapdoor for the RAM because, like I said, it's accessed from the top. And yes, it does have several missing screws, but that's not a big deal. So let's turn it on. I'll go into the setup first. I updated the BIOS to the latest revision. You can see it has a Core 2 Duo T7100 running at 1.8 GHz, which is actually the slowest CPU that they sold in this model, although it's still faster than the 1.66 GHz Core 2 Duo that's in my X60. There's the 4 gigs of RAM. So let's get out of this and just resume normal startup. The hard drive I put in it from that Toshiba has Windows 7 on it, so that's what we're going to be seeing. And there are the details. It's Windows 7 Ultimate, Service Pack 1. It still says Toshiba Satellite L305, because I did not reinstall Windows. And that's something that some people say is impossible, that you can take a hard drive out of one Windows computer and install it in a completely different computer, and it'll work. Well, in this case, it did. It automatically found and installed all the drivers it needed. It did not even ask me to reactivate Windows. I just had to recalculate the Windows Experience Index, which in this case is 3.1. The lowest score is for gaming graphics, but in general, ThinkPads are not meant for gaming, so that's to be expected. It has built-in Bluetooth as well as wireless and all your indicator lights there. The display is 1280 by 800 resolution, so it's a 16 by 10 aspect ratio. And it's a non-glossy matte finish, of course. The 250 gigabyte hard drive still has plenty of space on it, even with a lot of my applications installed. Especially video editing and capture and encoding software, because that's what I was mostly using my Toshiba laptop for. So it's still on this one. I now use my MacBook Pro for video editing most of the time, but for standard definition video I still use a Windows PC because that lets me do the higher quality deinterlacing and converting it to 60 frames per second. And just like my ThinkPad X60, it's still perfectly adequate for browsing the web and playing YouTube videos, and the built-in speakers don't sound too bad either.
All was most certainly well until an ill-fated day came to pass. The laptop was sitting perched atop a small table with its charger's cord gracelessly extended to an awkwardly located outlet, and as I clumsily blundered by, my foot caught the cord and dragged the laptop down with it. After this
It's like Euro Truck Simulator, except in real life. The only real fault of this computer is that the fan is noisy. It still works, it just makes this rattling sound. Most of the time, just taking it apart and cleaning it out and re-lubricating it is enough to fix the noise, but if that doesn't work, you can always replace it. It's not too expensive. But I figured if I'm going to do that, I might as well also replace the CPU with a faster one when I'm in there, since you have to take out the CPU cooler to get to the fan, so it's an easy upgrade once you have that all taken apart. It's not too difficult. Here's a better demonstration of the built-in speakers of some music. They don't get very loud, though. And don't have a lot of bass. There they are at the edges of the keyboard. And there's the ThinkLight keyboard light. And it provides just enough illumination to see the keyboard in the dark. So that's about it for the ThinkPad T61. After spending only $29.99 for this, plus another $12 for the battery. Compared to $1,899 for a new Retro ThinkPad, I couldn't be happier. So once I fix the fan and do a few more upgrades, the T61 will replace my Toshiba. It still works fine, but you can see how worn out the keyboard and the touchpad is. And the ThinkPad is in much better condition.
ThinkPad, a better place to think. Wherever you go, whatever you do, in the field, on the road, and under the sun. ThinkPad, a better place to think.